Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. In this first video lecture of week 11 for the course Applied Linear Algebra, today we are going to learn about scalar triple products. So the triple product, the product A dot into B cross C is called the scalar triple product of the vectors A, B and C. Its geometric significance can be seen by considering the parapet determined by the vectors A, B and C. You see over here in this figure, this is a parapet. And this parapet is determined by the vectors A, B and C. This vector represent B cross C. So the area of the base parallelogram is A is equal to B cross C magnitude. The cross product of B cross C and the magnitude of the B cross C vector is equal to the area of the parallelogram, and this area represented by this capital A. If this theta is the angle between the vectors A and B cross C, then the height h, this height h of the parallelepiped is equal to h is equal to a magnitude into cos theta. We must use magnitude cos theta instead of cos theta in case of theta greater than pi by 2. Thus the volume of the parallelepiped, the volume of this parallelepiped is equal to v. We represent the volume of parallelepiped, and this is equal to A dot H, and this is actually a dot product of A and H, A dot H, and this is equal to A mean B cross C magnitude, H mean A magnitude cos theta, and this is equal to A dot B cross C magnitude, magnitude of A dot B cross C. So this is the formula for the volume of the parallelepiped, magnitude of the scalar triple product A dot B cross C. Now therefore we have proved this relation: the volume of the parallelepiped determined by the vectors A, B and C is the magnitude of their scalar triple product. This is the volume of a parallelepiped, which is equal to magnitude of the scalar triple product A dot B cross C. Instead of thinking of the parallelepiped as having its base parallelogram determined by A and C, we can think of it with base parallelogram determined by vector A and B. In this way, we see that A dot into B cross C, A dot B cross C is equal to C dot A cross B. So the dot product is commutative, and we can write A dot B cross C is equal to A cross B dot C. The dot product is commutative, so we can write A dot B cross C is equal to A cross B dot C. Suppose that A, B and C are given in the component form. This is a vector A whose components are A1, A2 and A3. So vector A can be written as A is equal to A1i plus A2j plus A3k, and B is another vector, B is equal to B1i plus B2j plus B3k, and C is a third vector whose components are C1, C2 and C3. So vector C is equal to C1i plus C2j plus C3k. Then the scalar triple product A dot B cross C is equal to A dot determinant of, this is the determinant, A dot multiplied A dot dot A dot, this is dot product and this is the cross product of B and C. So I have already told you in the previous video lecture that we can find the cross product of two vectors by using determinant. So first of all, find the cross product of B and C by using the determinant. This is actually the expansion of determinant with respect to R1, and a determinant have the component, the first component in the first row of the determinant there are I, J, K, and in the second row there are B1, B2 and B3, and in the third row there are C1, C2 and C3. So expanding their determinant by first row, we obtain, this is the minor matrix, B2, B3 and C2, C3, I minus B1, B3, C1, C3, J plus B1, B2, C1, C2, K. And now the dot product of A with this vector, we can write A dot, this is actually A1, A mean vector A, vector A component, the first component of vector A is A1. So multiplying A1 component with this component, actually this is the component for I, so in this vector the component of I is this. So A1 multiplied this vector, we get A1 into determinant B2, B3 and C2, C3. Similarly, A2 multiplied with this determinant, we obtain A2 into determinant B1, B3 and C1, C3. And multiplied this third component with this third component, A3 into determinant B1, B2 and C1, C2. So dear students, we can find the scalar triple product of vectors by using determinant. And the determinant, there will be the components of vector A in the first row, the components of B will be in the second row, and the third the component of C vector will be in the third row. You see over here, this is a determinant. Suppose we have an example, but first of all I would like to tell you again about the scalar triple product. A dot B cross C. B cross C actually the cross product of B and C. So first of all, find the cross product of B and C by using the determinant. You see over here, this is the cross product of B and C. And now using the dot product of A with the vector B cross C. So vector A has these component. So A1 multiplied this component, A2 multiplied this component, and A3 multiplied this component, we obtain a scalar. This is actually a scalar quantity. So for the scalar triple product, we can use the determinant. And the determinant, the first row contain the components of vector A, the second row contain the components of vector B, and the third row contain the component of vector C. So this is example. Calculate the value of A dot B cross C, use the determinant method. Suppose we have a vector 2A, vector A 2i minus 2j plus k, and b is equal to 3i plus j plus 2k, and this is a vector C minus I plus 2j plus 3k. So find the scalar triple product for these three vectors by using the determinant. You see over here A dot B cross C. These are the components of vector A, these are the components of vector B, and these are the component of vector C. And we have already know about the expansion of determinant. Expand this determinant by using the first row, by using second row, or by using the third row, or expand the determinant by any column. So if we expand this determinant, we obtain the result 27. So A dot B cross C is equal to 27, and this is actually the volume of a parallel paper. So another example, if A dot B cross C is equal to 0, then calculate the value of T. T is a missing component in the vector A. A is equal to 2i plus j plus tk, and B is equal to 2i plus 4j minus 2k. Similarly, vector C is equal to minus 3i plus 2j plus 2k.
Now the scalar triple product A dot B cross C, and in the first row there will be the components of vector A 2, 1 and t, and the second row the component of B 2, 4 minus 2, and the third component in the third row the component of vector C minus 3, 2 and 2. Now expand this determinant by any row, by any column, we obtain 24 plus 2 plus 16 t, and this is actually equal to 0. This is given, the scalar triple product of A, B and C is equal to 0. So this result is equal to 0. So 24 plus 2 26. Now t is equal to minus 26 divided by 16, and after simplification 213 the 26 and 2 add the 16. So the value of t is equal to minus 13 by 8. So if we put here in this vector t minus 13 by 8, then vector A will be equal to 2i plus j minus 13 by 8. And after that, if we find the scalar triple product of these three vectors, then we will get the scalar triple product will be equal to 0 for this value of t. So we can verify the result. Put the value of t here and expand the determinant. The determinant will be definitely equal to 0. Now, example number 3, coplanar vectors. This is the application of our scalar triple product. And inshallah, in the next video lecture, we will discuss again the application of scalar triple product. Use the scalar triple product to show that the vectors A, B and C are coplanar. That is, they lie in the same plane. Dear students, coplanar vectors are that vectors which lies in the same plane. So if the scalar triple product is equal to 0, then the vector will be coplanar, and the vector lies in the same plane. So by using the scalar triple product A dot B cross C, by using determinant, this is the first row. In the first row there will be the components of vector A 1, 4, minus 7, and in the second row the component of vector B 2, minus 1, 4, and in the third row the component of vector C 0, minus 9 and 18. So this is the scalar triple product by using the determinant. So expand this determinant by using first row 1 into minus 1, 4, minus 9 and 18. You see over here, if we expand this determinant by first row, then delete first row and first column, we obtain minus 1 into determinant minus 1 into determinant minus 1, 4 and minus 9, 18. And taking 4, delete the first row and second column, we obtain a minor matrix determinant 2, 4, 0, 18. You see over here, minus 4 into determinant 2, 4, 0, 18. And for minus 7, delete first row and third column, we obtain a minor matrix determinant 2, minus 1, 0, 9. And now expand these determinant. You see over here, 1 into 18, 1 the 18, and minus 36. So minus 18 and minus plus 36, we obtain 1 into 18. And minus 4, 18 to the 36 and 4, 0, 0, and minus 7 into minus 18 plus 0. So after simplifications, we obtain here equal to 0. So the vectors, therefore the volume of the paper determined by the vectors A, B and C is 0. This means that A, B and C are coplanar. Vectors lies in the same plane. If scalar triple product is equal to 0, then it's mean that volume is 0, and when volume is 0, then the vector lies in the same plane. So the product A cross B cross C is called the vector triple product of vector A, B and C. A cross B into B cross C is equal to A dot C into B. minus a dot b into c. So dear students, in this lecture some points are important, and these points should be noted, that the scalar triple product of three vectors actually determine the volume of a parallelepiped. This diagram actually a parallelepiped. This one point is very important, that the scalar triple product is of three vectors a, b and c is denoted by a dot b cross c, and the scalar triple product give result and scalar, and the result actually show the volume of the parallelepiped. A dot b cross c magnitude mean the result never will be negative, because volume never will be negative. Volume is a scalar quantity. So a dot b cross c represent a scalar triple product and give result in scalar. But this absolute symbol, this magnitude symbol represent that volume will be positive. Volume considered will be positive. And volume of the parallelepiped is given by magnitude of a dot b cross c. This magnitude here represent actually the absolute symbol, that this value will be positive. This is not the magnitude of a vector, because a dot b cross c give a scalar quantity. You see over here in this slides, a dot b cross c, this result is totally is a scalar. So a dot b cross c give a scalar quantity, but the absolute symbol represent that, if we draw the absolute symbol here, this symbol will represent that the this value will be positive, considered will be positive, because this expression gave the volume of the parallelepiped, and volume never be negative. Volume is a scalar quantity. So the second question is that how to find a scalar triple product. Suppose we have three vectors a, b and c, then we can find the scalar triple product easily by using the determinant. And the determinant, there will be the first row there will be the component of vector a, and the second row there will be the component of vector b, and in the third row there will be the component of vector c. And if another applications, if the scalar triple product is zero, then it's mean the volume of the parallelepiped is zero, so the vector lies in the same plane. In this case the vector will be coplanar vector. Now inshallah, in next video lecture we will discuss again the applications of scalar triple product. And this is the end of this segment. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.